Heyo. Hey, I'm Eric. I'm making a game. It's called The Godkiller. And, I don't feel like doing much of a preamble today. I really don't. I just want to get to it. I'm going to do a demo here. Of something that's like kind of half working. Technically it's working, but it's definitely not working how I want it to, and it doesn't have the refinement that I want. So there's these things called bonuses. These boxes here that you see. Let me just hit play and I'll show you what I've got. These are special pickups that they don't give you anything except a sense of satisfaction. But that's worth something. In order for me to properly celebrate whatever achievement the player has made by stepping onto a bonus box, there has to be some kind of flourish to it. There's got to be a nice sound, a nice effect. So far, this is what I got. It's not that good. There's a few problems with it. There's a number of things for me to fix there. One is the sound effect, although it has, you know, some things that are good about it. I'll show you. Actually, I need to finish demoing here. Okay, so the sound effect, it always plays in whatever the current key is. So if I pick any of these other ones, you know, it changes the key. The point of that is that the sound effect can play on top of music and it won't be jarring. It'll actually be almost like you're adding something as you play to the music that is also playing. Okay, so things that are not so great about this. One, the sound effect, it's over really quick. I want something a little more extended. I think I can do that just by adding some timing that causes some more sound effect stuff to happen. Okay, second, the particle effect. It's just, it doesn't, I don't know, it's just not impressive. It's all kind of clustered right around the box, and then it's gone, and then it just doesn't look good. So I need to have a smoother dissipation. I need it to sort of go up into the air further. I want it to go like straight up at you, at your face. You know, it should make you feel something. It should make you feel just briefly a little bit excited. Unless you're, you know, a sociopath, then maybe you feel nothing at all. You're just dead inside. Oh, maybe I just hurt a sociopath's feelings. No, I didn't, because they don't have any feelings. They're just like, fine, say whatever you want about me. I'll kill you later. Okay, and then the third thing is, because I'm using a mechanism for special effects that has this built in, the ability to move after the special effect begins is it's disabled. So I move here and I can't move until officially the particle effect is done. So there's like three things there I want to fix. And thankfully it's only 5:37 in the evening, so I could spend a couple hours and probably get all three of those things done. And yeah, I just created a mission for myself that may ruin me, but I feel like I could get all those things done in this session. And if you know me, if you listen to me long enough, you'll know that I just signed up, and it'll get very grim here. if I'm not able to get all three of those things done in this session. So here we go. Let's get to it. First off, because I know there's going to be a lot of play and replay, I'm going to delete all the decorations in the level, because they are the main thing that makes it start up in a slow way. Actually, there's a different thing I can do, which is Okay. There's a different thing I can do which should have mostly the same effect, and it's worthwhile to test it out, so I'll do that. Okay, so I can go to Tools, Pro Builder, strip out the Pro Builder scripts. It's not that the Pro Builder scripts are slow, it's just that there's like so many of these decoration objects, which are like all the pipes and stuff that come down. And each one, you know, has the Pro Builder script executing for a noticeable amount of time, but when you multiply it by thousands, it slows everything down by quite a bit. Okay, so I did all that. The other thing I've been noticing is these guys, they keep getting created. Don't really want them to. I don't understand why they do. I'm kind of tired of messing with them. I think I've got the repro on it. They just get created every time I start the scene. So if I come back over here, because I don't feel like troubleshooting the axles right yet, I'll get to them later, but I'll just delete them for now. Alright, so let's save. And then I wish I would have timed it before. I didn't, so I'll just have to kind of go by memory, but I'm going to check and see like how much faster it is to start. Before it seemed like it was maybe 15 seconds or something along those lines, so let me try it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 5 seconds. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. Okay, sound effect first. So instead of playing a chord, maybe I'll do something a little more controlled by the effect. Change this to going to be a float. It's a stupid float comparison. Okay, we'll start. Let me think about this. We go. Say each one of these is maybe a like an eighth. So suppose I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's one bar. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Two bars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Three bars. Say X dun 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 dun. Okay, let's see, so that is 8. Let's take the next one. Dun 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 dun. Okay. Say, I want each one's dun 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 to be 1 second. Then the time per note is going to be 1,000 divided by 8, which is 125 milliseconds, 0.125f. Okay. What else? I also want to store. Okay, a little song. Int current. So maybe the first note could be -1. So notes, no pass, nothing. Figure out what the current note is that I should be playing. Int. Next note. Equals, let's see, elapsed. Let's see, int. Elapsed. Divided by time per note. That's how I do it. Okay. Remind me not to go crazy and write a full sequencer for music. It's just, it's fun stuff. Alright, let me see. Let's see if this does what I hope it will do. It's not compiling yet. Save all. Try again. Fucking cool. Now, also, let's hear it in some different keys. So the cool thing is, there can be music playing, and this sound effect will coincide with it. It'll sound good because it'll be in the same key. See, I changed the key mid effect. The tempo may not match what the song is doing. So, I like that. I think I can do something better. It's supposed to be a positive event. So if I just kind of swap these two, what should happen is that it'll have more of a rising sound to it, because this note number two is the high pitch note, and zero is the lowest. So go. Got one other thing I want to try. That was pretty good. So the other thing I want to try is just an arpeggio. Arpeggio? Something like that. I don't think I did this right. So zero should be the lowest one. Try one other thing. Well, I say one other thing. I might try 20 other things. Why am I limiting myself? What if I do? I Oh wait, I don't want this to go like this. That's probably gonna sound weird. Well, let's try it. A weird thing is it might pick up the new thing without me. No. I have to restart. Sometimes I really don't know why Unity tries to rebuild. When you're in the middle of playing, it seems like a really hopeful thing for it to do, particularly since it clears out a lot of the contents of variables, and it's like things you relied upon being there are gone when it rebuilds. Garbagey. So the challenge here is to make a satisfying ditty with just three notes. I don't know, I'll try another one. Dun 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 d liking that. It's just simple. Let's make it go faster. It's good. I'm good with it. Just to make sure I'm not passing up a better option, I'm gonna replay this one that I was liking before. And it'll be a faster speed too, so it's a new way to listen to it. It's kind of interesting. It's got a hectic feel to it. The last one best. So back in it goes. So I've fixed one of the three problems. We've got two remaining, and I feel like the one that I should make sure that I handle early is the one where I can't move while the bonus is playing. And I'm not sure. I'm not sure if I need to move it out of the effect as a more long-term thing. Or I've already left some kind of facility in here to not block the player. Been a while. I have this thing called a Mado effect. It's going to be in the main object. No, I meant the Mado effect to be like like navigation or something that was outside of the game that needed to change. So commands are disabled while the effect is still in progress. Okay. That one's not bad. I think that one's garbage already. All right, thinking about these all. No, because I made an effect not designed for that, basically. Whereas, yeah, I made an effect is meant to not handle timed repeating on each update type things. It's meant to just process one time, complete the action it was given, and there's no follow-up call to it again like I have in the normal effect loop. Number one's a pretty good option. It's like my first one to use at first glance. I don't have to change the code that much. It'd be pretty maintainable and understandable to just add this new method that would say whether or not an effect disables movement. Number three, basically I'd create some other kind of queue, add a third type of queue. So I've got regular effects, which I guess those are implying that they're always going to disable movement if there's any active. Then there's meta effects, which are handling a different type of thing, and then there's like even a third type of effect. Doesn't block movement. That seems overly complex without much benefit. So like the thought there would be to s- the hope there would be to simplify code by not making the regular effect loop have special case handling. But this other loop would be its own kind of complexity, added complexity. And its handling would be very much the same as perform, except for one detail, whether or not the effects block movement or not. If I could figure out there were more cases that could be kind of grouped together conceptually, that warranted a new type of effect queue, then I could see that. But right now I can't. I've gotten through coding up almost every feature of the game with the original effect loop, so I know there's just not a bunch of stuff that's just waiting to be fit into this new type of loop. So far number one beats number three. Number four, I know that you can use, I don't know if I have the right name of the Unity object, but they have like an animation sequence or animation timeline, and you can add different things that happen inside of it. So this one is maybe the only contender against number one. It's one of those deals where it's hard to guess in advance if doing something the Unity way is going to save you time. And I've had several things where I would try to do it the Unity way to save myself time, and it didn't save myself time. I end up maybe even scrapping that approach and just going to the code it myself way. An example of something that's right on the edge of just doing it my fucking self being better is the character animation. It's complex. Stepping through all those different dialogues and linking up the different objects, it's quite complex. And brittle. If you have to do an upgrade of Unity, I had to redo quite a bit of stuff there. I had to recreate some character models to get them to hook up to the animations. It's really hard to understand when the animation there doesn't work. So I'm going to say number four, because there's no great compelling feature add, or it's not bringing me something that's really obviously going to make my life better in terms of speed or in terms of new features. I think I'm just going to go with number one. I think it's unlikely that using the timelines or sequence, what do they call them, is actually going to be helpful for me. It might send me off to Stack Overflow or Unity Answers more than I want to. Okay. So going with number one, I'll leave these other ones up just in case number one turns out to be a dead end. Okay, so go to Effect. Yeah, see, already I was thinking up here that there should be some way to make it optional whether to disable the command input. So some past version of me is already on board with what I'm doing now. I use the word alive here, I think I'll be consistent. Okay. So if I do that, I come back to here and we'll say we will override public override. And say false. Okay, then inside of effects, here I've got to be a little bit careful. Okay, let me see who's calling this, and if I can just change. Just one place. It does see the caller here doesn't care about getting a number of effects back, so I don't need to continue returning that. I can do instead just have it return true if command should be disabled. Let's see. Okay, I gotta see, is this actually being called any place? It is not. So whenever I see code that's not actually being called, I don't have any future plans to use it, delete. That's how it goes. That's how you keep your code easier to maintain. No reason to be a hoarder, a code hoarder. I mean, it's all in Git. So that's one of the reasons why I use Git, even though it's just me. Right now it's contributing to the source. Okay. Over here I put in a comment that I'd use perform all, but I meant perform. Okay. Okay, that did it. Just testing some of the other effects to make sure I haven't broken the other effects. Okay. I've got two of the three things done. So that did it. I was real happy. I did not have to change the effects in some way that was hard to understand. And I think I never put that feature in before just because I didn't need it yet. And I was following a correct practice of not adding in features until you actually need them. Because otherwise, if you try to predict what you're going to need, a lot of times you're wrong when you actually get to that point. So, pretty happy with that addition of a feature. Okay, so the next thing and the last thing is to get this particle effect looking like something celebratory. Instead of a little mess. Let's see. And this might be really a boring part of this whole thing for people that are watching this, because I'm really just going to be tweaking and tweaking and tweaking. But, oh well. I'm not here to entertain you. Believe it or not, it seems like I might be, but I'm not. I'm not here to entertain you. I'm here to get work done. I do appreciate when you're here and you talk to me. That's cool. I do like when people get something out of the stream, but first and foremost, make the game. That's why I'm here. So let's see. So I have a duration of 3 seconds. My issue is that it's kind of over with real fast. Could it be that as soon as it gets outside of the shape, it stops? Maybe it was this thing I checked. Let me try that. No? Alright, let me scale this to some giant amount. Hit play, see what happens. So, in my mind, this box is not where the particles are bounded or stopping. It's where they can begin. So I think my settings there are correct. I had something like particle lifetime, something like that. If I sort of expect it to be, oh, what's this start lifetime? Well, if we just say it's 3, what happens then? There we go. Now we're getting someplace. Just say, okay. That was a major breakthrough right there. Oh, that's kind of neat. Let me do something else. So I think I'm gonna need the ability. This is gonna work, so I don't need to keep those around. Get rid of that. But I need some way to hide the box. Without without hiding the effect. So I just want to hide the box, not all its children immediately. Let me see, what's my code for hiding all the children? Okay, I'm just setting the renderer off. I think I don't need to call piece transform. I think I can just use transform set in the base, because the base will get called first, and then this code will execute. And I believe, I'll double check it, that the effect is coming from, or transform is getting set here, it's protected, okay, yeah, all good. Okay, so down here under performs, start it, and then let's say, the question is, if I disable the renderer of a parent object, does it also disable its children? I'll find out pretty shortly. Okay, I want that box to get hidden real fast, but not immediately when you touch it. So let's say, after 1/10 of a second. So what I think I saw is the first one, for whatever reason. Oh, shit. I got it. Okay, the first one that I worked on, I didn't save it back to the prefab. I've stopped. So now if I go to these guys, who don't have any overrides. Yeah, they got the big one. Okay, cool. So let's just try that. Not bad. That's not bad at all. I like how it kind of takes over, like it fills up the whole screen. Thank you. Yeah, there's no harm in just hiding the box right away. Instead of waiting that tenth of a second, there's no way you could tell. Yeah, maybe you could. Maybe you could. So, I keep on setting this number up higher. I know it doesn't have to be that low. So 3 seconds, number of updates could be 60 frames per second. So that would be 180. So I think occasionally I was getting over 100, because my frame rate is probably still high enough that after 3 seconds I can get there. Okay, so let me play with the effect a little bit more. I think one thing that might be nice is to just bring down the intensity of that material that's used for the particle. My theory is that since it's really super bright all the time, it might be kind of nice for it initially to not be quite as bright. That's not it. So it loop and play, and then I can open. Maybe it'll stay going if I come over here. Nope, it will not. All right, so I kind of have to tweak it, then play the animation, then tweak it, then okay, that's fine. Yeah, that's a little more interesting to me to look at. Let me try this and play again. I can't really see what it looks like unless I hit play, because they chose to outline the effect Oh, she's annoying. Okay, that looks like a little more three-dimensional. That's a pretty good effect. Looks magical. Okay. And if this seems annoying and repetitive, keep in mind that there's only going to be one bonus box on each level. So you go to it and here. Let us set up a little victory demo here, because I'm coming to the end of this. I'm going to take these guys and space them out a little bit. Okay. I'll make a little Easter egg hunt for myself, see if I can get them all. Let's go and set maximize on play and let's save. And I will quit the session after this little bit here, unless I see something really terrible that I gotta fix. Can't be many more. Oh, there's that one up there. I'll get that one last. Good chance it has an error right here. Yeah, it worked. It was fine. Huh. But it did something a little bit strange there that I didn't expect. Anyway, it's not worth worrying about. It's went to like an older version of the level. Oh, maybe I didn't save it, and that's why. That's might have been it. No, I don't think that was it. All right, that's a session. I gave myself three things to do. I was a brave motherfucker, and I did them all. I did all three things. I'm done. I'm victorious. And you, if you've watched this, have shared in my victory. That's great. Let's just keep inspiring each other with our victories, huh? Alright. Stopping the stream. Stopping the stream. Stop in the stream right now.